All right, so looks like Book is locked in. Oh, I knew it. He was going to pick Josie. Want to have more utilization here of the pokes and being able to beat out a lot of things that are available. The character that got him into our top eight when he was defeating, where he defeated Joey Fury.
Yeah, Bin Chang staying for the top eight, not taking a flight home.
Yeah.
Back to the Devil's Pit, man. Popular stage today.
Yeah, it's our new Arctic Snowfall. Anyways, lots of love, of course, to our team over at Bandai Namco Entertainment, the Tekken Project team, and, of course, Twitch and our sponsors, Kwanba, for supporting this event. We are about to get started here. On the loser side, we got Bin Chang going up against Book. Here we go.
Game number one.
Nice. Opens it up with the hook fist here.
Wow, weird input there. The jump back kick.
Yeah, maybe it's a mental thing. He's like, oh, no, he has execution error. Oh, my God. Uh-huh. He's so good with that parry.
Yeah, it's one of the best parries in the game.
Oh, yeah. Gives him good frame advantage, oftentimes giving him free attacks afterwards, able to interrupt. Here we go, goes for the double grab. Good break, but man, Bin Chang is not looking good right now. He's going to have to be careful. Oh, that's going to be a punish, and looking to close it out. Look at this.
Look at the pressure.
Yeah, just the pressure for movement alone. If you could do that to somebody, that's how you know you're able to really put fear into their hearts.
Yeah, Book using that back to him, closed out the first round. Bin Chang now with the defense, but again, the parry. And here it comes, LLRK.
Yeah, the nice health sweep pushing towards the wall. What's he going to do? One, two, again.
Another one.
Man, he's... Oh,
wow,
man.
Three in a row?
He got greedy. But he's testing, right? He's testing. He wants to see how he's going to react. And because of that, he didn't get a full combo, but it still did decent damage there. But interesting, you know, Bin Chang has gone for that down forward 1-4 a few times now. Oh, my God. Another parry.
Yeah, Bin Chang still has a pixel. Can he make this comeback?
Oh, nice mid option. And, you know, Book can play crazy, but he can also bring it back and reel it back in and play very compact at the same time. Oh, nice. He's going to get the follow-up here.
Uh-huh.
What's he going to do? The adjustment there. Nice. And just like that, close to, you know, 40% gone here from Book's life bar.
Yeah, nice block there from Book of the Crouch Dash 3. But here we go. Down 4-2 for Bin Chang.
Yeah. But, I mean, the way we are right now, it's going to be a challenge for Josie because Josie overall just doesn't do a lot of damage without walls. So she's going to have to definitely work for that damage or work for those pokes.
Yeah, he's got a good lead right now, though. Rage mode available for a Book.
Oh, he got him with the 1-2-3. Something that usually doesn't come out. He ended up fishing him for the mid attack there at the end. Again. You know, he's going to have to be wary about what he's throwing out because Book is ready. He is buffering that.
Oh my gosh,
the hook fist.
Yeah, Book looking for a parry wherever he can. Big lead. Set point for him, or game point for him, but Bin Chang answering back, gets the get up kick into the combo.
Yeah, and you know that was a big change with Jin Kazama in this iteration of the game. The ability for being able to combo from electric hook fist. Wow, he even adjusted and went for more damage there.
Man, he is so prepared for Josie. I don't know if Bin Chang should stick here. What do you think about that?
It's rough. I think Josie is not the answer either. It wasn't Claudio, it wasn't Josie, but who else can he have? I mean, is it maybe time for Kazumi? But I mean, I know
he went to character select.
Yeah, he's going to have to be thinking about this, you know.
Even if Book knows it, Kazumi is so much more unpredictable, right? Because even though the moveset is smaller, you don't know what's coming.
But that's not to say he hasn't trained against the character. You know he knows what to parry, what to launch, what to do. Oh, he's going to Claudio. He's going to tried and true, his main. Not his side girl. All right, here we go.
Yeah, the main?
The main. All right, let's see what stage you're going to be battling this out in. Looks like we're taking it to Violent Systems. Claudio Serafino, Jin Kazama. So one of the things to watch out for, you know, the trademark, the hallmark, I mean, it's going to be tough for Claudio. Claudio doesn't have the best arsenal of moves here. He has to be able to land the lows. They have to count. Mm-hmm. He has to be able to pressure in that regard and make everything else work. It's going to be tough for Claudio in this matchup because Jin has so much utility. He has moves for almost every single situation like that.
That parry was crazy.
That kind of sealed it away. You know, when you get in a situation like that where you have to deal with that movement, it gets kind of sealed away because you can't use it. Now, using other moves, this time getting a big counter hit there with the down forward too.
Wow, just threatening right now. He's got the blue stuff. Doesn't pull the trigger that time. And right now, life bar is pretty close. Starburst still available. Demon Paw says, I don't care.
Yeah,
get out of my face.
The great thing now about Claudio being in this matchup, it gives him an option to be able to go for some liberties with those mid pokes. Something that does way more damage than what Josie is able to do. So he's going to have to be wary of that. He's going to look for these opportunities to get that Starburst. He wants the glowing end. Yeah, give me the blue stuff.
His defense, though, definitely faltering there. Book closing out that first route, that forward 4-3, getting Binchang to duck.
Yeah, and you know, Book having that execution, being able to reflexively throw out that electric wind hook, which is always a threat. Mm-hmm. It's a mini Mishima waiting to explode. Oh my gosh, no punish, not in time.
Yeah, the mental alertness got him out there again. Parry on the orbital.
I can't believe he went for it again. Then 2-for-2, Book parrying that up forward 3 there.
I mean, even if Claudio does like a forward 3 in that situation, he's still going to get the parry, still going to get the punish.
It might be worse, and he has to be wary for that Superman punch as well.
That's
oh my god. This time going for the mid option with the crouch dash 1. Okay. He was ready for it. You can already see him buffering and looking for those situations.
Is it on reaction counter? Down back 3. Binchang might get on the board. The wall's in the way.
Oh no, the wall messed it up. He had an opportunity.
And the blocks. Binchang, can you get around? No!
And the delay there. Look at that. Book one round away for making it the most Untekken-like set that we've seen so far. It's not going to any final round
here. No, sir.
Oh my gosh, they spike. They trade blows.
Yeah, stuffs the hop kick. Book's still in control right now.
All right. And again, went for the attack there for mental alertness. He gets the hit. This is going to get to the wall. And the follow-up with standing two. Savage Sword. Oh, complicated wire. That's going to be it.
My goodness. Book making a statement here, eliminating Binchang. Binchang going home with seventh place.
A grab that you don't see too often. He went for the